God's word is the light of life. It is powerful. It's the glory and food for our spirit. Open your heart and mind as you receive truth and inspiration of God's word that will change your life forever. As God's servant, Pastor Chuks Eti, the lead pastor of Doxa Life International Church, leads you into a life of limitless possibilities.
And I have a good news. God has added to the church early hours of this morning, Mr. and Mrs. O'Malley. Glory! So, a baby boy that is bouncing. Hallelujah. So, another Doxalize member has been born. And maybe you'll be in Doxa Fragrance or Doxa Expression. I don't know. Hallelujah. So, we just show them some love. Okay? I think they're still in Federal Medical Center. And you can go there after service. And if it is possible, just go there and show them some love. Let that place be flooded by Doxa Life members. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Our time is already. Oh my God, oh my God. Okay, no challenge. Even if we share the grace now. Even if we share the grace, we've had a great service. You see, the things the Spirit of God can do in the life of a man, words can do it. But amazingly, the word is the Spirit. In a few minutes, I'm going to, maybe 15, 20 minutes, I'm going to try to start up something we're going to be dealing with. We're going to be dealing with it for several weeks. And you can't imagine what the topic is. Can somebody tell us by the Spirit? Is there any prophet? Prophet, your ministry is needed now. Anybody? Okay, living from God's perspective. Okay, another person. Prophet, don't fall my hand now. Use your prophetic eyes and prophetic nose. Wow. Okay, let's get to Jude. Jude chapter 1, we read from verse 17. I'll just try to give an intro. Can we all rise up on our feet, please? Okay. Rise up on our feet, please. Now, maybe after this Sunday and next Sunday, depending on how far we go today, subsequently, if not from next Sunday, the upper one, we're going to be looking at several characters that made a difference. And from each of those characters, we're going to be deducing the things that made them to make a difference in their generation. Now, I want to ask you a question. How many of you want to make a difference? You want to make a difference. If you want to make a difference, raise up your hand. Okay, I like that. And you're going to make a difference. I expected you to shout a louder amen. You know, if I say you're going to buy a Hummer, the amen, some people will be shouting. But can I tell you, making a difference is bigger, better, and greater than any riches you can think about. Okay, let's read together, one to go. But beloved, Remember ye the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. 18. How that they were told be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lust. These be they who separate themselves sensually, having not the Spirit. 20. But ye, beloved, build up yourselves on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. 21. Keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. 22. And some have compassion, making a difference. Go ahead. And others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. 24. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. I don't know if you were blessed just by reading, just by reading these scriptures. If you were blessed, can I see you? Just by reading. You know, the Bible talked about, it said, blessed are they that read it. There is a blessing that comes from reading the word of God. And I want you to know that, so that every time you read the word of God, just reading, there is a blessing that comes. And then there is another blessing that comes on people who don't just read, who do. Now, making a difference from the place that we read, you realize that one of the needs why we need to make a difference. Verse 18, 19 talked about how people are living. People have donated their lives to living according to their lust. That is, whatever comes, whatever desires they have, they go for it. Now, the truth is this, our world is becoming very, how will I put it? The darkness in our world is getting thicker and thicker. And we can't afford to do nothing. You see, darkness takes charge when light is absent. True of us. The Bible says, it said, gross darkness. Darkness will cover the earth and gross darkness the people. Wickedness is on the increase. You know, the other day, somebody was sharing with me about how the driver of his uncle killed him. The driver of his uncle killed him. I arranged with some of his friends, they killed him inside his house and took his car and some of his belongings. You know, wickedness is just the order of the day. And as it is, it's becoming more and more difficult, especially to really walk as a Christian in Nigeria. And people are thinking that is it possible for me to make a difference? Can what I do count? Can I make a difference? You know, one of the things I like about Jesus has come to seek and to save them that are lost. That is the assignment that Jesus came to do. That's one of the purposes of Jesus. He came to seek, to save them that are lost. He came to turn people from darkness into light. And you see, one thing about God, and I love about God, is that God has never given up on anybody. Every sinner you see today is a potential saint. And God wants you to see through his eyes. He said, these people walk in the flesh. It is the flesh that determines the things they do, not from the spirit. You know, there are two kinds of death. You have the physical death, when a man's body is separated from his soul and from his spirit. That's physical death. And then there is another death, which is the spiritual death, when a man is separated from God. Now, I want you to know something, that spiritual death is worse than physical death. But at most times, people are more afraid of physical death than they are afraid of spiritual death. Spiritual death is worse when a man is separated from God. If you are cut off from God here, the Bible says, while we were dead in trespasses, God sent his son to die for us. And you know, one of the things that is going to make hell fire or the lake of fire to be more dangerous is not even the fire. It is the absence of God. Because where there is no God, there is darkness. So, as a child of God, he said, making a difference. Can you take us to that place that talked about making a difference? Is it 21? Just. He said, keep yourself in the love of God. Is it 22? Just locate where, okay. He said, some of you and of some have compassion, making what? A difference. Now, let me start by saying, what does it mean to make a difference? To make a difference is to have a significant effect on a person or situation. To have a significant effect on a person or situation. Now, making a difference has to do with the number of people whose lives are impacted or affected or improved by you. And I want you to know something, that God wants you to make a difference. Now, in this making a difference, we are talking about individuals making a difference in the life of people, helping people to become who God has made them to be, and also solving societal problems. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Now, I want you to hear this. God has sent you here. One of the reasons why you were saved, why you are born again, why you are on earth, is not to make a living. And the earlier you realize that, the better. You see, because people don't know the reason why, when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. You see, because many people have thought that the reason why they're on earth is to make a living. You know, we call it making ends meet. And people think that that's the reason why they're on earth, to make a living. And you know, what that will reduce you to is what they call the rat race. A life of struggle. A life, you see, when your aim in life, I want everybody to pay attention. And, you know, some persons, help the person, anybody that is dozing by your side. It's too early to be sleeping. And I don't remember assigning anybody to pray for us all night for this service. Did I? Did I tell anybody that? Just in case I forgot. So if I didn't give you that assignment, you are not permitted to do. Just keep your eyes open. You see, it is the word of God that can change people. So when people think that the reason why they're on earth is to make a living, you know what happens? People get to a point that they become desperate and they can do anything because they just want to make a living. But you see, when you understand that the purpose of your life is beyond making a living, you are living for impact. You are living for contribution. You are living for effect. You see, your life will have a meaning. And the things that others are pursuing, we come looking for you. You see, that is one of the secrets to making, to living a meaningful life. Now, turn with me to Matthew chapter 6, 22 to 25. You see, the larger the problem, the larger the impact. The more, the thicker the darkness, the more effective the little light you shine can be. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? And that is why I'm so glad that we're in North Bank. I don't wish to be, you know, some persons can wish, oh, they're in GRA, where they are pastoring big, big people, where they are paying tithes. But I'm pastoring big, big people. Are you aware how loaded and how significant you are? You know, most times when people do certain things, it's because they don't know who they are. Now, let me say this. Okay. Just leave it there. Why I try to say what I have to say. I have 10, 15 minutes. He said, making a difference is a choice. You need to realize that. Making a difference is a choice. And as we begin to look at, go deeper and begin to look at various lives that made a difference over years, you will realize that it has to do with a choice. Making a difference is a decision. You make a decision that you are going to make a difference. Now, let me tell you this. Making a difference has nothing to do with your sex. Whether you're a woman, whether you're a man, it has nothing to do with your age. It has nothing to do with the money you have in your bank account. Because, you see, as you go through the scriptures, you will discover that there were many people who made a difference. Some of them were women. Some of them were children. Now, it doesn't even have to do with the situation you found yourself. Because there were people who made a difference. Somebody who was a slave. She was a slave, a little girl. Not just that she was a small girl. She was a slave. Had several things going against her. But she made a difference in the life of her master. Somebody will ask, who is that? A slave girl that was captured by Naaman. She knew she had something and knew something that his master needed. But the time will come when we're going to estray that little girl, and you will discover it doesn't matter where you are now, you can make a difference. It doesn't matter your sex, you can make a difference. You can change a life. I remember one of the things that doctor projected, one candlestick that had several other candlesticks. And how many of you have seen a candle? It takes one candlestick to burn, for a candle box to burn. Are you aware? Just one. Let one catch fire. Every other one will catch fire. Now, let me tell you this. Making a difference has nothing to do with number. Do you know the number of persons, how many we are now? We are too much. If we make up our mind to change Makodi, we are too much. We are too many. If God can set all of us ablaze, and if God can set a burning desire to make a difference in the life of everyone here, I can tell you, it's a matter of 5 years. Makodi will be a different place. North Bank will be turned upside down. You see, Jesus knew the impact and the effect of this. He just selected 12 men. And then at the upper room, there were just 120 people that were set on fire. He left 120 people. He knew he had more than enough people to engulf the whole earth. And you know, after some years, what was said about those people? He said, the men that turned the world upside down, they have come. I want that to be said about me. What I'm looking for is not to be said that I own estates. My desire is not to be said that I had cash. My desire is not to be said that I traveled around the whole world. My desire is not even for people to say that I'm a good preacher. My desire is to be seen that I impacted lives. That has been my heart desire over the years. And I remember when time in the year 1998, I got admission to study in Abia State Polytechnic. And I told myself that I cannot leave this school without them knowing that somebody like Jesus, that Jesus reigns on the campus. My desire was not, you see, whatever you are first a Christian before whatever. You are first a Christian before a student. You are first a Christian before a pastor. You are first a Christian before a nurse. So what should be driving you is not your profession. It is making Jesus known. It is revealing Jesus to your world. It's so that Jesus might be known to the world through you. That must be the burden of everyone. You know, I went somewhere yesterday and they delivered a paper and they said something that over 70% of the youth in our country or the state are on drugs. Over 70%. And you can imagine, if that continues, the hope of the nation. Now think about it. You see, you are just preoccupied just thinking about yourself. You see, that is the key to living a useless life. One of the recipes of living a useless life is to be preoccupied with yourself. And probably next week, if I'm able to finish with the introduction, we're going to start with the life of somebody, Boaz. Boaz. And we need to understand one of the things that made Boaz to become one of the great grandfather of Jesus Christ. Now, the truth of the matter was that Boaz was not supposed to be the person. There was somebody who was supposed to occupy that position. But it was a life of self-occupation that removed that person from being. But we're going to look at that in details. Now, I was so amazed the first time we went into Avis and went into that yard. Some churches have been existing for 10 years. They don't have the crowd that were being pastored by drugs. That place choked. They don't have the congregation that were being discipled by drugs. And we are seated comfortably, just thinking about our knees, just preoccupied by mundane things, just being preoccupied by one enemy is against you and another one is against you. And darkness is ravaging the whole earth. And when God, the reason why God left you here is so that he knows that you are light, you can handle darkness. Making a difference, another thing I want you to know about making a difference, that it is your calling. It is your assignment. It is your calling. Your calling is so that you will make a difference. Your calling is not so that you become the president of your nation. Now, let me tell you this. Being whatever you are is just a means to an end. It's not the end. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Whatever your aspiration is, you want to become the best doctor, you want to become the best engineer, you want to become the governor of your state. It's not the position. It is just a means to an end. What are you going to do with that position? You want to have money. What is the purpose of money in your hand? Is it that your neighbors will know that you serve a living God? That's useless. Is it that your village will know that you serve a living God? That's useless. The purpose, any money that is not used to change lives is useless. And you see, what people think that people think that, you see, that having money has to do with, that's what makes a man rich. You see, actually people are poor. That's why they do certain things they do. You know, people carry money buried in the ground is a sign of mental, is a sign of insanity. You see, people carry money that is meant for the good of everybody and put it, hide it in their house. That is poverty mentality. But that's your calling. Now, I wish I have all the time. Now, I want you to understand something. Unfortunately, we come to church, we think that church is religion. We come to do religion in the church. And then people just think that it's only on Sunday that you become a Christian. Then on Monday, you know, have you ever seen people who said they are doing something wrong? They said, this is business. This is not church. That's they compartmentalize their lives. That this one is Christian life. This one is academic life. This one is business life. So when we come to church, we speak in tongues. But when we go to business, we can cheat. And then we still come back and say, eririmasa, eririmasa, eririmasa. You see, one of the reasons why our world is covered by thick darkness is because the lights have refused to shine. I went somewhere. One of our brethren had a challenge, and I went to the prison. I saw a Christian, somebody who attends one of the big churches in town. Not just that, a worker, tongue talking. And you can't believe what they were doing. They were collecting money for people to be able to visit. Visit who they want to see. And that is not what it's supposed to be. I remember one of the Mopo guys, when we were trying to drive in, he said, where are you going to? I said, we want to go and see somebody. He said, no, you can't just go in like that. You need to drop something. He said, drop something like what? He said, if you don't drop something, you have to go and pack the other side. I said, thank you. We turned. I went and packed that far. He think he did something to me. I just walked majestically past him and went to where I was going. Don't conform. We got there, we saw the Christian. He was the one collecting offering, stupid offering from people. And when he saw me, he couldn't collect from me. But he was still, that's a Christian. And you go to several places, that's what you see Christians. There is no difference between Christians and unbelievers. I can't forget one time we went to make, international passport. A Christian was in charge of the whole place. You know, when you go to do international passport, the prices are different. As you walk in, they can look at you and say, it's 30,000 naira. Something that is supposed to be for 10,000 naira. And it will be Christians. This will they finish this thing and go to church and be speaking in tongues. Why? How are we going to make a difference? And when the guy was told, he said, no, that just negotiate with them, talk with them, is something they're going to use to fuel the generator. Is it my responsibility? Why am I paying? After paying you money for passport, I will still give you money to fuel your generator to make passport for me. You see, my heart broke. You know, these things we say that we can laugh, but you see, that is one of the reasons that darkness has covered the earth, because there is no difference between the light and darkness. And then when we read further, you discover what Jesus said. He said, if the light in you is darkness, how great is that darkness? If a Christian that is supposed to be carrying light, now that the light he's bringing out becomes darkness, he said, how thick is that darkness. You go to our universities, there's no difference between Christian lecturers and unbelieving lecturers. Christian lecturers are collecting bribe, sleeping with girls, creating all manner of bottlenecks. Many persons will go to write to do their masters, they can't graduate because they say that before you graduate, present, defend your project. It becomes a feasting. You have to organize a feast for the people. And the people spearheading these things are Christians. How are we going to change this nation? You see, it is we think that the problem of this nation is with the leaders. The people that are being led are more dangerous than the leaders. In fact, the led are the reason for the kind of leaders we have. So the change begins with you. And you must make up your mind. It is your calling. Your calling is to make a difference. Now let's read this place. Give us the Message translation. As I try to I'm just trying to lay a foundation. He said, the light of the body. Can you give us the Message translation? He said, the light of the body. Go ahead, Message. Okay. Sorry, this is where, give us chapter 5. Chapter 5. I think I'll read this other one later. Chapter 5, verse 13. 13. So that you understand, that is our calling. Chapter 5, verse 13. Okay, he said, let me tell you why you are here. Did you hear that? Come on, did you hear that? This is Jesus speaking. He said, let me tell you why you are what? So, and you thought he's going to tell you so that you can make more money. Now hear what he said. He said, you are here to be salt seasoning that brings out the God flavor of this earth. Come on. Are we together? Now, does that seem like the thing is what you are pursuing? Huh? You thought that when they gave you employment letter, maybe to teach in a school, or to work in a place, that why you came there is to collect salary. Two of us. Eh? Two of us. Come on, let me hear you. Two of us. But God is telling you that is not why you are there. You are there to season the place. You are there to bring the kingdom of God into that place. He said, if you lose your saltiness, how will the people taste godliness? You have lost your usefulness. That means your usefulness is actually in your making a difference. So that means God is saying, if you are not making a difference, you are useless. You are not supposed to be living. You are useless. You know, that brings to mind the parable that Jesus told about a tree, a fig tree that Jesus planted, or the master planted, and was doing everything possible, put manure, put everything for the fig tree to bring forth fruit. And every season when he went there, the fig tree will not produce any fruit. He said, look, what will I do to this fig tree that I have not done? What is supposed to be done to this fig tree to produce I have not done? He said, look, I'm going to cut it. Why is he encumbering the ground? Why is he occupying space? You see, now let me tell you this. You know, we quote a scripture, I shall not die but live. We don't finish it. Why should you be alive? To eat pounded yam. To eat egusi and salad. He said, okay. You see, that's a recipe. Somebody receive it. Try it when you go home today. You see, I shall not die, but live. That is a reason to declare what? To declare what? So the reason why you shall not die, but live is for a reason. He said, you have lost your usefulness. He said, And where will you end up? You end up where? But that's not, that will not be your portion. So you make up your mind not to end up where? In the garbage. Now, give us the next verse. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Here is another way to put it. You are here to be light, bringing out God colors in the world. God is not a secret to be kept. We are going public with this. As public as a city on a hill. Those of you, when you carry your Bible, you cover it with magazine. Those of you who are ashamed to carry the Bible, those of you who are ashamed for people to know that you're a Christian, you can see that you are abusing your purpose. Yes, you know, when I was in school, I told myself something. I said, if unbelievers that are wasting their lives will carry their girlfriends on their lap openly, one useless girl is sitting on the lap of another useless boy. And they are laughing. And they are doing it unashamedly. Why will I carry the bread of life and hide it? Why will I carry something that they need and hide it? It's not, that devil has not been born. People are smoking away their lives and they do it openly. And then you are a Christian. Even your classmates are not aware that you are born again. What a useless life you are living. And that was one of the things I made up my mind. At times when we are waiting for lecturers, I will stand in front of the class. I say, good morning, everybody. I bring greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Come on. This Ajibo Christianity has no future. You can be an Ajibo or quiet. But when it comes to doing church or Christianity, put some radicality inside it. Let not fall from your head small. This gentleman, gentlewoman Christianity, it has no impact. Can let them say you are fanatical. Can you imagine you know what unbelievers, how openly they are advertising the devil? That's why he's telling you God is not a secret to be kept. It is something to announce on the hilltop. He said, you are the light of the world. No man lights a candle and puts it under a bushel. He said, so let your light shine. Beloved, you see, maybe next week, my time is up. The Bible says you are the light of the world. Do you know something about light? Light brings illumination. Light is the reason for vision. In case you think that the reason why you are seeing is because you are for your eyes. Without light, you are blind. Without light, your eyes is not working. You know, it reminds me of a story of a man that has stayed abroad, had kids. After many years, brought them to Nigeria. You know, there, they don't know what is up Nepa, down Nepa, Nepa, this one. They don't know the meaning. So while those small children were there, Nepa took light in the night. And those women shouted, Daddy, I've gone blind. Because it is a mystery to them. They don't know what, they thought that they went blind because they couldn't see. They said, don't worry, welcome to Nigeria. They're just welcoming you to Nigeria. It's just our way of welcoming people to Nigeria. You know when you come, when you travel out, and once you arrive the airport, you just know that you have arrived in Nigeria. Even the air is different. The atmosphere is thick darkness. And how long are we going to keep complaining when we can make a difference? You know, somebody will say, oh, when I become the governor of Benue State, eh? Hey, eh? Just forget it now. They say, come and do, come, let's go. We say, no, come, let's do something for, no, don't worry. When I become the governor of, in fact, I will change everything. I will make sure there is church in all the streets. It's a lie. In fact, they will be begging you to come to church. You will not pay. You won't come to church. If you, when God, you know how God rates things? He said, he that is faithful in little. He didn't say will be. He said is. You are already, by what you are doing now is a prophecy. It's already a prophecy of what you will do in the future. If you are tiffing 10-10 kobo, and you say it's just this 10-10 kobo, your parents give you money, you go and buy something, you will not return change, put it in your pocket. When you become the governor of this state, woe betide that state. That's how it begins. Making a difference is a calling. It's our calling as the light. You know another thing about the light? Light is one of the things that brings about energy. Do you know light? In the recent technologies, you see that light is used for sterilization, for purification. So that means as a light, you can sanitize your environment. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Now, the question I'm asking you, as a light, wherever you are, how are you sanitizing your environment? Like Doc will say, are you part of the problem or are you part of the solution? It's a choice, but I've made up my mind. And I want every one of you to join me to be solutions in our world. I said, I want to announce to you that because you are here, there is hope for Nigeria. Amen. Because we are here, there is hope for North Bank. Amen. North Bank will no longer be known for evil. You know, North Bank is a headquarter. Yeah? Is it? It's a headquarter. But it's changing. And somebody will ask why. You want to know why? Because you are here. Can you say, because I'm here? So next week, we're going to build on it. Making a difference. What an impact, effect are you making in the lives of people? Do you know that you can begin to mentor children around you now? You see, I don't know why are unbelievers ahead of us? Somebody will say, why? Eh? Somebody said mentality. Now, can I tell you why? When I'm saying unbelievers ahead of us, it's not the money. Money is not the measure of a person. Do you know there was a time cultism was something that was just for people in the university? Do you know unbelievers are passionate about the assignment of the devil? They have started initiating people in the primary school. They have started, that's when they start coaching people into a bad life. But you are comfortable sitting in the church. When was the last time those children around you that you tried to put God inside them? You see, can I tell you this? In life, there is no room for vacuum. Anybody you don't put Christ in, somebody will put devil inside the person. So, the question is this. How long are we going to allow the devil to be having a field day in our nation and in our land? You have been called to make a difference. Making a difference. Are you ready? Make up your mind. It's your calling. I'm going to build on that next week. I want you to bow down your heads as we pray. I want you to know that life is too big to be all about you. Life is too big for you to just be living for yourself. And you see, when you live for yourself, you are endangered. I want my life to count. He said, I am the light of the world. He said, let me tell you why you are here. Let me tell you why you are in that office. Let me tell you why you are in that school. Let me tell you why you are living in that compound. Let me tell you why you are living on that street. Let me tell you why. Jesus is telling, let me tell you why you are there. You are there to salt the earth. Salt is one of the cheapest of the cooking ingredients, but it makes a whole lot of difference. The little things you do, the little things you say can make a whole lot of difference. It starts by believing that you can make a difference. It starts by believing that you can make a difference. Somebody go ahead and pray. Lord, I want to make a difference. I want my life to count. I don't want to be part of the problem. By next week, we're going to build on it. And probably we'll begin to look at the characters, several characters, and some of the things that made them to make a difference. You see, the greatest gift that you can give to somebody is the gift of the gospel. Somebody that you refuse to preach to today can become the pain, your pain tomorrow, or the pain of the nation, or the pain of the city. Let's go all out. Let Christ be exalted in us. Now, I want to make a call. You cannot make a difference. You cannot live this kind of life that we're talking about without Jesus in your life. The beginning of making a difference is by having the difference maker in your life. Until the difference maker, who is the light of the world, comes into your life, your life will not be set on that mode to make a difference. No Jesus, no life. No Jesus, no peace. You are here, wherever you are, you want to give your heart to Jesus. You can raise up your hand. I want to pray with you. Thank you, my brother. I can see that beautiful hand raised up. Now, if your hand is raised up, can you walk to the front here? Jesus is real. Jesus is wonderful. Jesus loves us. He wants to change our lives. Then, in turn, we can change our world.
Can you hear him knocking?
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Can you hear him knocking?
Just go ahead and sing it.
Someone's knocking at your door.
Oh, Jesus, thank you.
He's been waiting for so long. Can you hear him knocking? Can you hear him knocking?
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is at the door.
This may be your last opportunity. Can we take it one more time?
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is at the door.
Can we take it from someone's knocking at your door? Can you go ahead and pray? Put your right hand on your chest. He loves you. He loves you.
Someone's knocking at the door of your heart.
He loves you. He loves you so much.
He's been working for so long.
Can you hear him knocking? Can you hear him knocking?
Ha.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is at the door.
Can you pray? I want you to stretch forth your hands, everybody. Stretch forth your hands towards my brother. Jesus said, he that comes to him, he will in no wise cast away. The Bible says there is a way that seemeth right unto a man. The end thereof is the way of destruction. God loves you. I'd like you to repeat these prayers after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for today. I thank you because you died for me. Today, I acknowledge I'm a sinner. Today, I ask you to come into my heart. Today, I declare you as my Lord and Savior. Today, I receive eternal life. From today, I will follow Jesus. No going back. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Now I pray for you. Father, we thank you for your son. You said he that comes to you will in no wise cast away. Thank you because his sins are forgiven. Thank you from today he will live for you. Every yoke of darkness over his life is broken. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for saving him. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You're welcome to the family of God. God bless you. You can go with them. They will talk with you briefly. Just go.
This message was brought to you by Doxa Life Media. To enjoy more of the glory life, which is the God kind of life, join us at Doxa Life International Church, House of Mercy Auditorium, Uniagri Road, North Bank, Makurdi, Benue State, on Wednesdays by 5 p.m. and on Sundays by 8 a.m. For more inquiries, you can reach us with the following numbers: 081-180-43332 or 081-487-92013, or send a mail to us at doxalifechurch@gmail.com. Visit our Facebook page, Doxa Life International Church. God bless you.